Hello, I'm Fast Lawyer. Today we're doing a Let's Play Big Rumble Boxing Creed Champions in VR using the Unreal VR Injector by Praydog. Now, this is developed by Servios. It was released back in September 2021. And this was Servios' first non-VR game. As you guys know, they released Creed Rise to Glory VR. And it's probably now their most well-known title, but they also came up with Raw Data, which was one of the bigger VR games back in its day. Sprint Vector, very underappreciated title. It was like really big for like a short time. Electronauts, but then they came out with The Walking Dead Onslaught, and unfortunately, I think that's where they went downhill. And then after that, they came out with this non-VR game, and it sort of makes sense because this has the same MGM license, so it makes sense for them to make a non-VR version. But this was not received very well. It's mixed review status on Steam. Controller support, I guess, was iffy on release. I can verify though that it works perfectly fine with an Xbox One controller. I've had no issues. The Unreal Engine VR Injector works great. You know, really good 3D visuals, but obviously when you have Creed VR Rise to Glory, there's no reason to play this, you know, because that has full motion controller support and you're actually boxing, you're actually getting a good workout, versus here, you're just button mashing on a gamepad. This is pure arcade boxing. It's a very simple arcade boxing. You know, maybe if you compare it to the old school Street Fighter, but I don't know. I think Street Fighter has more depth than this. I think this is a simplified version of Mortal Kombat or Street Fighter. So let's go ahead and let's just play. We're going to do a new one. And obviously we're going to go with Adonis Creed since he's the main character in the movie. We're going to go on rookie campaign because I'm not very good. And you start to see some of the flaws in this. As you see these 2D screens here, this is the intro to the game. Text boxes. This is now obviously because I'm in VR, I can look around this screen. You guys only see the text screen on the YouTube recording, but I'm in VR, so I can actually see the whole stadium, not just the text. But you know, this is not good production value for the cost of this. So this is normally $40, which is a crazy price when you look at this. I know the license is there for you know, Rocky and the Creed movie series, but when you look at this, you're like, wow, this is not good. This is not good at all. This is just text. What is this a visual novel? What's going on? This is just poor quality, no animations, no voice acting, just text. But anyways, let's just skip through all this. Let's just start the fight. Like I said, in the YouTube recording, you're only seeing the 2D screen, but I'm in VR, I'm actually seeing the whole stadium. There's a lot of text here to scroll through. I'm not sure why, it's not very good. That's what's up. Okay, so. All right, so let's see how well I do. This is pure button mashing. Dream come true. There, so just so you know, there's a light attack and a heavy attack, and you can dodge or you can guard. So let me show you the guard. Here's the guard. He's on the attack now. Rushing out a jet. No blocking that. Wow. That defense is unbeatable. So obviously I'm on rookie, so it's not as hard as, and as you see, I got the super as well, so I'm gonna go ahead and do that. So that's my superpower. They both get, as you see, he's close to it as well. But I'm gonna try to knock him down twice.
Nice dodge. He dodges. Tearing him to shreds.
He uses his special ability to get me knocked out. Which is unfortunate.
Here we go, Buck, seeing offensive output. He's taking control of the fight. That's time.
Both men coming out strong.
A lucky block.
He flips the hit. Stupendous speed.
And as you can see, there's a lot of just facing the wrong way kind of crap. And you can also obviously grab. And I got my super as well, so I'm going to go ahead and use that.
Come on, Grandpa. No way, this can't be happening.
Hell yeah.
Oh, of course, you're able to. It's actually a lot harder to
a solid round.
So I'm pretty close to my super, and that's probably what's gonna win me this game right here. I might win here. We'll see.
I'm on the edge of my seat.
Didn't see that coming.
A solid punch. Give it all. He's been working his opponent down. This is his chance. Oh, stumbling.
But we'll see if I can get up here. It's going to be very close. It's just button mashing here. And this is probably the game here. That's it. That's game over.
Ain't no stopping.
Obviously, this is a rookie challenge. I did lots of mistakes, but a lot of it's just button mashing, as you saw. The 3D visuals actually look good. I haven't seen any problems. This is all by default. This is on OpenXR and native stereo, so no modifications at all to UEVR. This is straight out of the box. It really works perfectly. I haven't noticed any issues at all whatsoever. I mean, I noticed some issues with the game, you know, as far as clipping and all that, but I think that's just part of the game. My personal opinion as far as UEVR is it works great. But my opinion of the game is just, there's a reason for the mixed review status. This is not a good game. It's really just a button masher, and there's just not enough depth. Maybe if you have a friend and, you know, you want to do some local PvP, some couch PvP, this might be good for that. But otherwise, you know, some 1v1. But other than that, I just, against the CPU, I mean, I don't know. I think there's better. I think you'd have more fun playing Mortal Kombat or Street Fighter than this. There's just not a whole lot here. And this is just really bad quality here. I mean, Rocky just went, oh, oh, oh. I mean, that's awful. I mean, you expect more for the $40. Either a better game or better, you know, production values. And the production values here, I mean, they got the license, but it's not a very good use. I don't know, some people might like this, these mini games, but they're pretty, if you ask me, they're just button mashing. Okay, I'm already tired of these. I did alright. Never played these mini games, so forgive me. It's just follow the buttons, really. But this is basically the story. I don't think it's very good at all. So would I recommend this? I mean, obviously I recommend Unreal Engine VR Injector. It's brought so many new games to PC VR. But unfortunately, I was curious how Serbios made their non-VR game, and I certainly wasn't interested in playing it in non-VR. I think I got this game in a bundle, so I didn't spend $40, but I did buy it in a bundle. But unless you get it in a bundle, I wouldn't recommend this game at all. I think there's just much better of this type of game. You know, like I said, I think Street Fighter more fun to play, Mortal Kombat more fun to play. So I just don't see the point of this. If you're just aching for a simple arcade boxer where you just button mash and, you know, something that you can couch PvP with your friends one-on-one, you know, while you're drinking your beers and just, you know, especially if your friends aren't normal gamers, I think that's fine because this is something that you can easily pick up and play. You know, you don't really have to worry about, you know, like Mortal Kombat has more depths, but some of those combos can be quite difficult. This just really doesn't have that difficulty, in my opinion. A lot of it's just button mashing and twitch reflexes as far as either dodging or blocking. And there was just a matter of see, I'm just repeating the same thing right now. Of course, I am on rookie difficulty, so keep that in mind. If you want to see the real difficulty, you got to go higher, but I was losing on the regular, on the normal difficulty, so not going to lie there. Barely standing. This might be over soon. Stay low out there. He scores the knockdown. 1, 2.
Hell yeah.
So you gotta give him like a second. Oh, I thought I docked him out at the last second. It might be time to rethink their strategy. He takes a big hit.
He's got his into a hit. Rock him to the mat.
One, two.
You keep this up,
three,
and you can be a ringer.
Four, five, six, seven.
Let's see if he gets
eight,
up. Nope.
Ten.
It's over.
Ain't
he's
no
down
spot
for the count. Okay. I mean, it's beginner difficulty, so I'm going to forgive the enemy AI there. It was a little bit more difficult, or actually a lot more difficult on normal difficulty. I was losing quite steadily, but I'm also learning. So I mean, my total playtime is probably about an hour right now, maybe less. But no, I just can't recommend this game. It's not at the $40 price tag, but I can recommend the Universal Engine VR Injector if you already own this game. And if you get in a bundle, then I could recommend it. You know, it's cheap fun for couch co-op, you know, with a drunk friend. I think that's what it's good for. So I'd give the Unreal Engine VR Injector a perfect 10 out of 10. I didn't notice any flaws. Obviously, use an Xbox One controller or a gamepad. This game has a negative reviews button of supporting gamepads, but mine worked perfectly fine. But yeah, I'd rather play Creed VR as well, so, you know, rise to glory. Anyways, I'm Fast Lawyers. It's been my Let's Play Big Rumble Boxing Creed Champions in VR, even though it's a non-VR game. Thanks to the Unreal Engine VR Injector by Praydog. Anyways, thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed this. If you did, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And yeah, don't pay full price for this. You know, get it in a bundle. Or, you know, if it's $5 or cheaper, or maybe even $10. I don't know. Just depending on if you have a friend to play couch co-op with. And I could recommend this for you. Otherwise, I'd pass on it. Anyways, thank you. Have a wonderful day. Goodbye.